Spinal adjustments provided by Dr. Chad Rolfson. The Spinal Tuning Chiropractic Center is a Des Moines area low flat fee per month unlimited chiropractic care practice. When life happens, just adjust. Schedule today at SpinalTuning.com.
It's the Daily Planet for Monday, July 27th, 2020. I'm Jimmy Olsen. Taylor Swift, she sold 1.3 million copies of her new album, Folklore, in just 24 hours. Also, the top 75, these are the 75 greatest boy band songs of all time. Topping that was I Want You Back from the Jackson 5. This is according to Rolling Stone. And then it was Bye 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 from NSYNC. Candy Girl, New Edition, made it in the top 5. I Want It That Way, the Backstreet Boys. Also, Moon in there from BTS from 2020. What Makes You Beautiful, One Direction. Also, You Got It, The Right Stuff. New Kids on the Block, Mbop, Hanson, also made it in the list. Summer Girls, LFO. And then I Like It The Way, The Kissing Game from High Five, SOS, The Jonas Brothers, also in that list. I'll Be There, The Jackson 5, Sherlock from the Korean group Shinee, Back for Good, Take That, Motown Philly, Boyz II Men, It's Gonna Be Me, NSYNC, also The Story of My Life, One Direction, Spring Day from BTS, Everybody, Backstreet's Back, that's the Backstreet Boys from 1997. Daydream Believer from the Monkees in 1967 made the list. Also ABC from the Jackson 5. Why Do Fools Fall in Love from Frankie Lyman and the Teenagers, 1956. Pass the Duchy from Musical Youth. And then Sucker from the Jonas Brothers. You can, of course, find that full list if you head over to RollingStone.com. Now, Luke Combs, he had a bet that he lost, and he was going to have to be vegan for 90 days. And he made it about a third of the way through, and he was not able to finish it. Yeah, this was a bet that he made last year and lost with his keyboard player. Now, it'll be interesting to see how he's going to make that up. Trying to improve your trivia knowledge with a few random facts for your Monday. The word tragedy comes from the Greek word tragedia, which translates to goat song. Now, no one's quite sure why, but the theory is that it refers to actors dressing as goats and mythical creatures in plays. Also, the president gets free rent at the White House, but he pays for everything else, which includes groceries, housekeeping, parties, vacations, and toiletries. There are 7 countries where people have won more Nobel Prizes, than Olympic medals, including Israel, Myanmar, Guatemala, East Timor, Yemen, Bangladesh, and St. Lucia. James Brown and MC Hammer both never had a number one hit on the Hot 100. The United States changed the spelling of Puerto Rico to P-O-R-T-O Rico when it was annexed in 1898. Now, the name was not officially changed back until 1931. Okay, emojis. There is actually an encyclopedia. It's the Emojipedia. Yeah, check it out. They've got some new ones that came out last October, and the ones that people have used the most so far are the white heart, yawning face, brown heart, otter, and hand making the pinching gesture. Of course, you can go check out the Emojipedia for more of those emojis. You know, there's always a study for everything, and with a new study, they say that you can have days where you eat insane amounts of food without causing health problems or gaining lots of weight. Now, that's according to this new study that says the insane amount of calories once in a while, and it will not cause you long-term health problems. Our bodies can handle and process the extra burst of calories really well as long as you do not do it too often. So some good news for that, when you have your epic cheat days, when you eat the donuts and the pizza or both, supposedly you're okay. People are more motivated than ever to finish their travel bucket list. In fact, they feel like most of us has put off traveling because of we figured we'd be around to do it another day. But with the pandemic, they're realizing that might not be guaranteed. So according to a new survey, more than half of Americans say that they are now more motivated than ever to finish their travel bucket list. In fact, 76% have already started planning their next trip. A few years ago, Starburst listened to its biggest request of starting selling the packs with all pink flavors, well, no messing around. Yeah, no orange, no yellow, no red. Well, the all-pink packs, they've been on sale during the summer since then. Now, Starburst just announced that they're going to sell all-pink packs year-round permanently from now on. So, believe it or not, there is a Guinness Book of World Records for an insane Jenga tower. It was an Arizona man who set a Guinness record for stacking 485 Jenga blocks on top of one vertical Jenga piece. It took him 2 hours, and he even broke his own record last year, which was 353 pieces. Now, if you're celebrating a birthday today, happy birthday. You are sharing your birthday with Winnie Harlow, who's 26. Also, Cheyenne Kimball, who's 30. Taylor Schilling, 36. Kenny Warmold is 36. Also, Jonathan Rice Myers is 43. Alex Rodriguez, 45. Peter Yorn, 46. Maya Rudolph, 48. Triple H, 51 today. Also, Julian McMahon is 52. Sasha Mitchell is 53. Donnie Yen, 57. Bill Engvall is 63. Yahoo Sirius, 67. Maureen McGovern, 71. Peggy Fleming is 72. Betty Thomas from Hill Street Blues is 73. Bobby Gentry, singer of Ode to Billy Joe, she is 76. Norman Lear is 98. Now, today, National Scotch Day. It was on this date in 1586, tobacco was the first brought to England from Virginia by Sir Walter Raleigh. And in 1940, Bugs Bunny made his official debut when he teamed up for the first time ever with Elmer Fudd in a Warner Brothers cartoon called A Wild Hare. Now, this was the first cartoon with Bugs Bunny in his final redesign instead of the earlier, much more goofy-looking Bugs. It was on this date, 1953, the Korean War ended. 1960, Vice President Nixon was nominated for the president at the Republican National Convention in Chicago. 1974, the House Judiciary Committee voted 27-11 to recommend Nixon's impeachment on a charge that he had personally tried to obstruct justice in the Watergate case. In 1976, John Lennon received his green card, granting him permanent residency in the U.S. Tina Turner filed for divorce from Ike this date in 1976. 1983, Madonna released her self-titled album featuring Holiday, Lucky Star, and Borderline. Purple Rain, starring Prince, opened nationwide in theaters this date 1984. Pete Rose passed Ty Cobb's record for the most singles in a career with number 3,503 this date in 1984. Nancy Wilson of Heart married Almost Famous and Jerry Maguire director Cameron Crowe in 1986. They divorced in 2010. 1992, Boston Celtics star Reggie Lewis, we lost him. He collapsed at the Brandeis University basketball court during practice. He was only 27. In 1995, the Korean War Veterans Memorial was dedicated in Washington, D.C. It was the 42nd anniversary of the end of the Korean War. In 1996, a pipe bomb exploded at Centennial Olympic Park in Atlanta, killing one person and injuring more than 100. And we lost Bob Hope to pneumonia this date in 2003 at the tender age of 100, the comedian extraordinaire. That is your Daily Planet for Monday, July 27th, 2020. I'm Jimmy Olsen. You can follow along on iHeartRadio as well as the Google Play, the Apple Podcasts. You can even find these stories and many more. Just find me on Facebook and Twitter, My Buddy Jimmy. That is what you want to look for. Also, you can subscribe as well to my YouTube page, which is My Buddy Jimmy 101. Find these, more of these episodes of this podcast and many more. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to share it with others as well.